3, 2,
imagine for a second that you're a phone. So instead of seeing the world like you usually do, it might look something more like this. Flat. You don't really know where you are except when some satellites tell you where you are, and every time you go inside, they don't work, so you get lost. You have no idea if there's a cat nearby, or a table, or a person. It's impossible to move around the world because you don't know that the world exists. But now imagine you could see. What would you do with that sight? Hi, I'm Nat.
And I'm Lo.
We go behind the scenes at Google, learning about different stuff we're curious about.
And when we've asked you guys what you're curious about, a lot of you have said Tango, which, if you don't know, is a project to help give phones and tablets real-time 3D tracking capabilities.
So in this episode, we're talking with Johnny and Larry to find out exactly what that means.
All right, tell us everything you know about Project Tango.
The basic idea behind what we're trying to do is giving devices the same sense of motion in space that people have. Because we are physical 3D beings, interactions that allow you to just use 3D space is something that I always found really compelling.
The gist of how Project Tango works can basically be broken down into three main components. There's motion tracking, area learning, and depth sensing.
Motion tracking is a lot like your computer mouse. Tango has cameras that act like my eyes, and when I move the Tango left and right, it's estimating that motion based off of the camera, the gyro, the accelerometer.
These little green dots here are the interesting corners and edges. When she waves her arms, the dots start turning red.
I don't know if you get those.
Area learning is a lot like your memory of space and places that you've been.
So if you closed your eyes right now, you'd roughly remember where you are sitting on the couch.
Next to a fern.
Yeah. Next to a fern, how far away the walls are, mm-hmm. as well as perhaps how you even got to this room. So that spatial memory is what we call area learning. The third one, depth sensing, is detecting surfaces. So the fact that there is a solid floor here, a wall, the couch has these sides. And then we use the depth sensor to flash infrared pattern that actually can measure the distance to objects in the environment.
Allowing the virtual world of your device to interact with the physical world in new ways.
When we show adults Tango, they touch the screen and we sometimes have to like push their back so they'll take a step forward. But when I hand it to my nieces and nephews, which are 6, 7, they actually get it within 4 or 5 seconds without me saying anything.
Imagination is a big component of this.
Yeah. I really enjoy seeing when app developers are starting to be creative with the tools.
In theory, Tango could help power lots of different applications.
Since, for example, GPS doesn't actually work that well indoors, one potential application for Tango could be indoor navigation.
I could just search for things around me, and it can actually tell me exactly where in the store that is.
Maybe even assisting people who don't have the ability to see.
We use the location estimate from Tango to read aloud the names of the rooms as you walk past it.
It might also help us quickly measure things without one of these guys.
Oh. Yeah, I'm gonna measure low.
Oh, I actually know how tall I am, so that's a good test.
You are 5'6", it says.
5'7", guys, so.
Or if you want to capture a 3D scan or measure the volume of a room. So imagine you being able to go to an unbuilt space and just hold up this little magic window and say, this is what's going to be here.
Another big area that Tango has a lot of potential for is in gaming, both in virtual reality and augmented reality games.
So you could be playing 3D Jenga.
Or trying to solve a 3D puzzle. Or making a fort in your house so you can actually walk into.
Oh, I didn't really leave myself very much space, did I?
I've always wanted to be able to play hide and seek with characters in my house.
And my personal favorite, killing killer robots. I think this is made too easy.
And my personal favorite, petting a virtual dog and cat.
I think she likes that.
Like, what are the hard problems right now that you're working on?
Understanding what you can't see is something the system doesn't do today. It can only see the front sides of objects. Mm-hmm. So if you look at a chair or a table, it doesn't actually realize that there's a back side of the chair or a bottom side of the table. We cover the cameras with our hands. We just move it around and shake it. And the device is basically getting both blinded and dizzy at the same time. So we need to be able to quickly and gracefully recover from those situations.
So for the last year or so, Tango has had a developer's kit out there. And this summer, Lenovo came out with a phone with Tango built into it. But it's really interesting to think about a future where Tango could just be in any device that we use.
Including phones, wearable devices, drones, RC cars, maybe even space robotics.
Tango isn't something that you can easily sum up in a sentence what it is, just like you can't easily sum up what it means to see. Because just being able to see unlocks a lot of abilities.
I just view the work that we're doing to be trying to answer the question of where are you? If computers understand motion the same way we do, we can start to interact with them in a different way.
We know that there are a lot of you probably out there that have a cool idea for what Tango could be used for. So we wanted to do something where we get to see what all those ideas are. So if you tweet with the hashtag #MyTangoIdea, we will share those with Johnny and Larry, we'll retweet the best of them, and hopefully they're going to inspire a really awesome future to be made.
Pronuts!
Yay!